I always just thought I'd show this. It's a quick vid. I was going to do a more detailed vid on this, but I haven't got the time with work and a lot of other things going on. So just a quick vid on this maintenance wagon, which is ESU. It's been out for about a year or so, and I managed to pick one up recently. Although, well, I was going to pick one up when they first came out, the cost put me off, because they are about 150 quid UK pounds. So, but I got this one pretty cheap, in full working order. And it, model number is 36030. It comes in three different liveries, red, green and yellow. And it's DC and DCC, works in both. And it's two rail and three rail. In the box, you get a conversion kit to convert it to three rail, which is really unique. It's really good the way they've done that. Get the tool to insert the three rail skid, or you can convert it back again that easy with a switch on board. Get a detail pack as well, adding extra details on. The box looks like that. The background there. So I've got it on the Z21, which has got the Z21 hardware built into the smart rail, which is logged onto the system now. So I'll just run over some of the features. The actual paint and the detailing on the wagon is really crisp, really nice. First feature is the head and cab end lights. As you can see, they're red now. Swap direction and they turn white, and it's the same at the other end of the cab. That's a nice feature, really nice. Now we've got, just bear with me, you can switch on the left hand side outer cab lights or the right hand side, which you can see now. They're controllable individually, left and right hand side. Really nice, just controlling it on the Z21 app at the moment. Got the internal lights. Just bear with me. There we go, sorry. It's got a bit mixed up there. Internal cab end lights, as you can see. It's got some detailed tables inside, so you can put figures in there, but I've not figured out how to get the roof off. These lights at each end are controllable separately. You can dim them to different brightnesses, or you can have a delay on the switch on if you want on the lights. And you can have a delayed switch on the side lights as well, or just come on quick. So really nice. Yeah, so when you take the door panel off, they're on magnetic latches, which are really nicely done. I've got it running on the smart rail now. As you can see, it gives you a precise speed in kmh. You can also adjust remotely the maximum speed you've reached, average speed, distance travelled. And you've also got a hold, a freeze button as well, and you can also turn the display on off and on remotely as well, which I think is really good. So of course you could use this wagon for speed matching your locos if you wanted to. Wouldn't be a problem at all. And everything's remote control, so you can turn the display off and on. There we go. And of course control all the telemetry feedback you're going to get. Or you can reset. I'll just reset that. So all in all, it's a very handy little device, or wagon, or, you know, it is a true engineering telemetry feedback wagon, which the other one was the Fleischmann Quad 5555 was the other version of something similar to this. And if you look underneath, you can see a sensor on the axle that takes all the information, and there's a switch as well to do from DC to AC, and it's really well made. I mean, it's a really weighty wagon. There's a lot of stuff in on board inside. You've got two displays, you've got one on each side, and of course you've got the lighting on both sides as well. I've added on some details on the side there. Yeah, you also have a light at either end as well, at the top of the wagon as well, and the rear window, which you can turn off and on in conjunction with the side LEDs. If you look in the reflection of the TV screen, that's the lights on the other side. Or you can have both. It really is a unique wagon. I think it's well worth the money. What I like about the display as well, the display is set at an angle. It's got a slight camber to the display. And so it's, you know, it's really easy to see. You can adjust the settings, the brightness settings, on all the lighting on board. And I'd say it really is worth every single penny, because it's a high quality model, this. It really is. And the other feature is it's got a battery pack up, so take it off the track, it still works for any dirty track, etc. You can adjust the time as well, the battery on the actual coach. You can adjust your milliseconds as well, which is really good. And of course you can do speed measurements. It's doing 48 kilometers per hour. So all you take that reading, which you can freeze the reading on the coach as it's going around using the ESU handset or a similar handset, and have full control of the actual telemetry feedback that you're viewing via remote control. Take your reading of your coach, sorry, of that particular loco that the coach is logged onto, and then put the coach on the next loco you want to speed match, put it on the same speed settings on the controller, then just adjust the other loco accordingly, taking the readings from the coach. That's just another way of speed matching. And there's many other ways of speed matching and setting up via decoders and CVs, but this is just an easy way using this particular coach. Or you can just use it sat in the yard as some eye candor.
I'm gonna love you like nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine. High as a mountain and deep as a river, come rain or come shine. I guess when you met me, it was just one of those things